बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। आज मैं एक थ्योरी डिस्कस करने जा रहा हूँ। थ्योरेटिकल अप्रोच कर रहे हैं हम डायामैग्नेटिज्म पे, लेंजेवन थ्योरी ऑफ डायामैग्नेटिज्म। ये आइडिया क्या है, लेंजेवन थ्योरी क्या आइडिया शो करती है? ये तो हमें पता है कि हमारे पास जो डायामैग्नेटिक मटेरियल्स हैं, इनके पास इवन नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन एट से के, क्योंकि पेयर की फॉर्म में होते हैं, वे से के इफेक्ट को कैंसिल कर देते हैं। तो स्पिन मोमेंट जो है वो कैंसिल हो जाते हैं। देयर विल बी ए लिटिल अमाउंट ऑफ ऑर्बिटल एंगुलर मोमेंटम या ऑर्बिटल मोमेंट, मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट। ऑर्बिटल मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट यानी इन डायमैग्नेटिक मटेरियल्स देयर आर इवन नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, दैट एग्जिस्ट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पेयर। These electrons are orbiting around the nucleus as well as around their own axis. Now for paired electron, they will cancel the spin magnetic moment. But there is a little amount of orbital angular magnetic moment related with each atom. Now, when we provide external magnetic field, when we provide external magnetic field, it influences influence the orbital motion. Like the lenses are, when the external magnetic field causes the modification in orbital motion, then it will opposes the external magnetic field. It will magnetize oppositely to the applied magnetic field, and that behavior is called diamagnetism. Langevin theory describes the change in angular velocity Langevin theory describe change in magnetic moment Langevin theory describe magnetic susceptibility is independent of temperature. This idea is called Langevin theory of diamagnetism. What is the core concept? What is the core idea? The core idea is that magnetic field is applied. It causes a change in angular velocity, it causes a change in angular momentum, but the magnetic susceptibility for diamagnetic material is independent of temperature. We have to prove this for explaining Langevin theory. कि हमें ये प्रूव करना होगा कि चेंज इन एंगुलर वेलोसिटी होता है तो कौन सा होता है, कितने अमाउंट का है, चेंज इन मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट है तो कितने अमाउंट का है, मैग्नेटिक ससेप्टिबिलिटी टेम्परेचर के पे डिपेंड करती है या उससे इंडिपेंडेंट है। नाउ उनमें से मैं एक को ले लेता हूं, जैसे इनमें से पहला है चेंज इन एंगुलर वेलोसिटी। चेंज इन एंगुलर वेलोसिटी orbital angular velocity. Before applying magnetic field, what will be the angular velocity? We know that electrons are orbiting around the nucleus due to the Coulomb attractive force between electron and the nucleus. So we can say that Coulombic force provides the centripetal force. Centripetal force is provided by the Coulombic force. Centripetal force is mv square over r. Coulombic force is ke square divided by r square. E elementary charge for proton and electron. Now r r ke sath cancel ho. So what will be mv square over r? It is equal to ke square divided by r. My aim is to find the orbital angular velocity. We can change this velocity v, linear velocity, as r to omega. So far before the applying magnetic field, we can write it as m r square omega naught square is equal to k e square divided by r. So we can write omega naught square is equal to k e square divided by m r cube. That is, before applying magnetic field, the angular velocity omega naught is equal to k e square divided by m r cube under the root. Let we call it as equation 1. Now what is angular angular velocity before applying magnetic field? Electron little amount of magnetic moment kis angular velocity sa show kar hai, and that is omega naught. And वो हमने कैलकुलेट कर दी. Now what will happen if we apply the magnetic field? After applying magnetic field, now electron is a moving charge, and moving charge having magnetic field around it. Now when it such charges, moving charges are entered in a magnetic field with certain velocity, it will experience force. So we can call that force for electron as, in a simple vector form, the force is F is equal to Q V cross B. Now the force on electron is F is equal to minus E V cross B. पॉजिटिव चार्ज पर राइटवर्ड फोर्स लग रही है, तो नेगेटिव चार्ज पर लेफ्टवर्ड फोर्स होगी, नेगेटिव साइन है. ठीक है, पॉजिटिव चार्ज अगर अप डिफ्लेक्शन लेता है तो नेगेटिव चार्ज उसके अपोजिट डाउन डिफ्लेक्शन लेता है. सो द फोर्स इज फॉर इलेक्ट्रॉन इज माइनस ई. दिस इज कन्वेंशनली टेकन फॉर द पॉजिटिव चार्ज. नाउ इफ द मैग्नीट्यूड इज टेकन, इट इज इक्वल टू वी बी, एंड वी कैन राइट इट इन एंगुलर वेलोसिटी फॉर्म ई r omega into b. This is magnitude of the force. ठीक है, now what will be the resultant force in case of external magnetic field? When we apply the magnetic field, what will happen? So when we apply the magnetic field, the net force is, now centripetal force is provided by two forces. One, the Coulombic force, and second is that magnetic force that experiences by the moving electron. So we can write centripetal force as mv square over r is now equal to Coulombic force is k e square divided by r square, and the magnetic force is here find out by minus e r omega into b. Now if we rewrite this linear velocity in angular velocity form, we can write it as m r square omega square by r is equal to k e square over r square minus e r omega into b. R cancel with r, then m r omega square is equal to k e square divided by r square minus e r omega into b. अगर इन तमाम फैक्टर्स को हम लेफ्ट हैंड साइड पे लेके आए तो इक्वेशन विल बिकम एम आर ओमेगा स्क्वायर प्लस ई आर ओमेगा बी माइनस के ई स्क्वायर ओवर आर स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू जीरो। तो सॉल्विंग फॉर ओमेगा, लेट ओमेगा स्क्वायर भी तो छोड़ दें, तो ओमेगा स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू, तो आपको एम आर पे डिवाइड करना होगा। तो हियर जब आप एम आर पे डिवाइड करेंगे तो आर खत्म हो जाएगा, तो इट विल बिकम प्लस E omega B divided by M, R R के साथ कैंसिल हो गया, और यही एम आर जब इधर डिवाइड करेंगे तो माइनस के ई स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाय एम आर क्यूब, दिस सम इज जीरो। नाउ इन दिस इक्वेशन ओमेगा स्क्वायर इज नाउ ई बी ओवर एम इन टू ओमेगा प्लस के ई स्क्वायर ओवर एम आर क्यूब इनटू ओमेगा पावर जीरो। नाउ द एक्सपोनेंट इज हियर, द एक्सपोनेंट इज जीरो, हियर द एक्सपोनेंट इज वन, एंड हियर द एक्सपोनेंट इज टू। दिस इज सम काइंड ऑफ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन इन फॉर विच ए इज वन, बी इज E B divided by M, and C is minus K E square divided by M R cube. Solving for omega, solving this quadratic equation for omega. Let me solve this equation for omega. Omega is now equal to minus B minus E B over M plus minus B square E B E square B square over M square, B square minus 4AC minus B plus minus B square minus 4AC, 4 A is 1 and C is 1 minus K E square divided by M R cube, this is C, and root divided by 2A, 2A is 1. Now omega is minus E B divided by M plus minus, let me solve this, E square B square divided by M square minus 4 plus 4 minus root minus plus K E square divided by M R cube. Now if we use the denominator 2 into this root, it will become 4, it will become 4, here it will become 2, and in dono pe divide kar diye, idhar bhi divide kar diye, idhar bhi kar diya, wo is inside jayega to 4 ban jayega, to ye 4 is 4 ke sath khatam ho gaya. Now equation will become omega is now equal to minus e b divided by 2 m plus minus the equation become what, e square b square divided by 4 m square plus, what is this k e square over m r e cube under the root, this is omega naught, and in this square form it is now equal to omega naught square. This value is taken from the equation 1. Now in this equation, what is this M? M is relative stiffness. So when M is relative stiffness is always greater than the rest mass. When this M is greater, then this factor omega naught square will be much greater than this factor E square over E square B square over 4 M. Means for relativistic mass, this omega naught square is much greater than E square
बी स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाय 4 एम स्क्वायर.
सो इन द सिंपल केस वी कैन राइट द इक्वेशन नाउ. ओमेगा इज नाउ इक्वल टू माइनस ई बी डिवाइडेड बाय 2 एम प्लस माइनस अंडर रूट ओमेगा नॉट स्क्वायर. So if we take this side minus EB divided by 2m plus minus root khatam karenge to ise plus or minus ki form mein likha ja sakta hai just omega naught. Now if we take this side on it as minus plus omega naught is equal to minus EB divided by 2m. So what is this? This is initial angular velocity. This is final angular velocity. So final minus initial are initial minus final. If either it modify, so it will be taken. It will be taken in the form of difference. And if if external magnetic field causes the decreases in angular motion, it will be taken in the form of difference. So we can write it as, what is this? This is change in angular velocity and it is equal to minus EB over 2m. So according to the Langevin theory, when external magnetic field is provided, it causes the change in angular velocity of the electron. Because for diamagnetic materials, there is only little amount of angular momentum, orbital angular momentum. So when we apply the external magnetic field, it causes the modification in orbital angular velocity. See? So the change in angular velocity is minus EB over 2m. This change in angular velocity is also known as Larmor frequency. This is Langevin idea of diamagnetism. Okay, what is the change in angular velocity after modification in orbital angular motion?